Dear students, welcome to the online learning class for the subject Fundamentals of Agricultural Economics. Today we are going to see about law of demand. So we have seen in the last lecture that demand is nothing but the quantity of commodity that a consumer willing to buy at a specific price, place and time. So we mainly focus on the price. So at what price, how much quantity the consumer wants to buy it. So we have seen that the price and quantity demand relationship as demand schedule. So we have a demand schedule here. So the when the for mango, as we seen in the last class, so when the price of mango is rupees 5 per kg, consumer demands 5 kg of mangoes. When the price is reduced to 4 rupees per kg, he demands even more. So when the price is still further falls, he demands much more quantity of demand. So this forms the law of demand. So when the price of the commodity increases or changes, the quantity demand also changes. So that change is known as law of demand. So in this case, when we see that when the price of the commodity changes, that is decreases from 5 rupees to 2 rupees per kg, the quantity demanded increases from 5 kg to 20 kg. So it is vice versa also. So when the price is increases from 2 rupees to 5 rupees, the quantity demanded is reduced from 20 kg to 5 kg. So in this demand schedule, it is clear that when price of the commodity increases, the quantity demanded of that commodity decreases. So when the price increases, consumer tend to buy less of that commodity. When the price of the commodity decreases, they will buy more of the commodity with the price they have. So in this situation, we can say that when the price increases, the quantity demanded decreases, and when price decreases, the quantity demanded increases. So there is the inverse relationship between the price and quantity demanded. So law of demand shows the inverse relationship between price and quantity demanded. So we have seen that price and quantity demanded plotted in the graph. So when the price increases, the quantity demand decreases. That's why we are getting a negatively sloped curve or negatively sloped line. So this law of demand is derived from law of diminishing marginal utility, as the addition to the quantity reduces the diminishing utility. So law of EQ marginal utility, since it is also based on price. Here we use a word, ceteris paribus. This word means keeping other things constant, or keeping other things same, or keeping other things do not change. So the demand is influenced by some other factors too. So this law of demand tells that when price increases, the quantity demanded is decreases. So if the income of the consumer increases, the demand will change. The taste and preference of the consumer also decides the demand. So while keeping other things same, when price only increases, the consumer will follow the law. Now let's see what are the determinants of the demand. So the determinants of demand are, the first and foremost, price of the commodity, shortly known as P. So price of the commodity is the major factor that influences the consumer demand. So if the price is increases, the consumers will tend to buy less commodity. So it is for not only for agricultural goods, it is common for almost all goods. So if the price of paddy increases, if the price of sorghum increases, price of maize increases, the quantity demanded of them will decrease. Then income of the consumer, So income of the consumer positively influence the demand. So if the consumer income is say 5,000, he will purchase less quantity of rice for his consumption. When the income of the consumer has shifted from 5,000 to 50,000, he will get rice as much as possible. So the quantity demanded will be high. So then next, price of related goods. Price of related goods means related goods for coffee, a related good is tea. So we can simply tell them as substitutes. So related goods also affect the demand of the particular commodity. For example, when tea is priced high, that means from 10 rupees to 15 rupees it has shoot up, means the consumers will go to consume of coffee rather than they will choose tea. That means when the price of the commodity increases, that is tea increases, the quantity demanded of coffee increases. So that is also determines the demand. Then finally, taste and preference of the consumer. So this taste and preference of the consumer should not change, and that if the consumer really likes a particular commodity, the demand will be more. So these things are determinants of demand. So quantity demanded is influenced by price, which is noted as P, and income I, and price of related goods known as PR, and taste and preference of the consumer. These four are the determinants of demands, and this law of demand tells that other things remain same, ceteris paribus situation, that is when price increases, the demand decreases, the quantity demanded decreases. So we are keeping the income and this price of related goods and taste and preference of the consumer as constant. So we are keeping them as same. So it just tells that the relationship between the price of the commodity and the quantity demanded. So this is what the determinants of demand means. So there are four determinants. One is price of the commodity, another one is income of the consumer, and price of related goods, and finally taste and preference of the consumer. So law of demand only deals with the price of the commodity. So by keeping all other determinants as constant, if the price changes, how the demand affects is explained by law of demand. So based on these determinants, law of the demand is classified into three. One is price demand, and another one is income demand, and third one is cross price demand. So it tells the relationship between price and quantity demanded, and it tells the relationship between income and quantity demanded, and then this explains the relationship between the cross price. Cross price means price of related goods. Price of related goods, how it affects the commodity, our commodity. So let's see in detail about the types of demand. So in types of demand, first one is price demand. So it explains us the different quantities of commodities that consumer demand for different prices. So it simply tells the relationship between price and quantity demanded. So when price increases, the quantity demanded decreases. So there is inverse relationship. And then the second one is the income demand. So different quantity of commodity that the consumer demand for different income. Let's say that when the income is 5,000, his demand will be some 100 kgs. When the income is more than that, the quantity demanded will be higher. So there will be a direct relationship between the income and the quantity demanded. Then the third one is the cross price demand. So the cross price means the price of related goods. When price of related good increases, the quantity demanded of the commodity increases, and vice versa. So everything is vice versa. When income decreases, the quantity demanded decreases. So price of related goods, for example, tea price increases. When tea price increases, coffee demand will be higher. Coffee demand will be higher. So there is a positive relationship between price of related goods and quantity demanded. So one more type of demand is there, that is derived demand. This type of demands are direct demands. Direct demands means they occur from the changes. This one results from another activity, that is when we want to produce more rice, the demand for fertilizers will go up. That is called derived demand. We doesn't want to increase the fertilizer demand, but we want to increase the rice production. So for rice production we need fertilizers and rice seeds, etc., and chemicals, etc. So in order to increase the rice production, that fertilizer demand will go up. That is called derived demand. So it refers to demand for a factor of production. That is, factor of production means here fertilizer is derived from the output. Let's say with another example, if the people of a country want to live in houses, and there will be a huge demand for buildings. So if the government decides to build more buildings, the demand for cement and steels and other construction materials will go up. That is also called as derived demand. So we doesn't want to increase the demand of that goods, but when we are moving for an objective like production, so we are in need of this demand. So these are all the types of demand. So far we have seen law of demand and the determinants of demand and types of demand. Now we are going to see how this price and the income affect the demand curve. So when the price, when there is change in price of the commodity, so the increase or decrease in demand occurs. So due to change in price of the commodity, increase or decrease in demand occurs. Let's see that with the example given here. So when the price is rupees 10, one quantity is purchased, and when the price is rupees 5, three quantities are purchased. So this follows the law of demand. Okay, now let's see from here. When the price is rupees 5 to 10, when it increases, and the price increases, so the quantity demanded from 3 units to 1 units, so it decreases. So when price increases, the demand decreases. So the quantity demanded decreases. So this is the first situation. And then when the price, let's see from here, when the price is rupees 10 and it is reduced to rupees 5, so here the quantity is increased from 1 unit to 3 units, that is increases. So when price decreases, there is increase in demand. So due to change in price, we see increase or decrease in demand. So either here or here. So when it moves here, it is called as increase in demand. When it moves over there, it is called as decrease in demand. To one unit, from 3 unit to 1 unit, when it moves, it is called a decrease in demand, because the quantity demanded decreases from 3 unit to 1 unit. So this is what happens when the price changes. When the price changes, there occurs increase or decrease in demand. Now let's see when the income changes, what will happen to the demand curve. Now when the income changes, extension or contraction of demand occurs. Let's say that the consumer is having an income around 50,000, that is shortly denoted as 50K. So his demand is noted as B. Now when the income increases, when the consumer's income increases, he will demand more quantities. As he have more money, he will demand more quantities. Let's say that his income increases to 1 lakh rupees, that is 100k rupees. So the demand will shift upwards, that is, that will extend the demand. So new demand line will be there. So it is called extension. So when the income increases, there occurs extension in demand. So the demand curve will extend outwards. So when the income is reduced, let's say now 20K, when the consumer income reduces, he will buy less quantity. So the quantity demanded will be very low from the previous one. So he will purchase this quantities. So the D double dash. So when income decreases, there occurs contraction of demand. So this is called as contraction, and this is called extension. When income increases, extension of demand occurs. When income decreases, contraction of demand occurs. So we have seen the change in price, how it affects the demand curve, and we have seen how the change in income affects the demand curve. So when the price changes, increase or decrease in demand occurs within the curve. So when the income changes, the curve itself shifts upwards or downwards. So this is the difference between these two. So far we have seen that law of demand and determinants of demand and types of demand, and how this demand curve is affected by price and income. And finally we are going to see the exception to law of demand. Some cases will not follow law of demand. That we are going to see in the next slide. So we know that when price increases, the quantity demanded decreases, and vice versa is known as law of demand. Ceteris paribus, other things remain same, that is income, taste and preference of the consumer and price of related goods remain same. This situation prevails. So there are some exceptions to law of demand. The first one is Veblen effect. Veblen effect is nothing but some people think that the things with higher price will give them higher utility. For example, diamond, they will purchase diamond even at a higher price, even though it is price is still going up, they use it to purchase because it gives high utility for them. Similarly, gold also. So when the consumer think that it is a prestigious good, they will purchase more and more of good even though it is priced high. So when price increases, they will purchase more number of that commodity. So it is known as Veblen effect. It is reported by Veblen. That is why it is called as Veblen effect. Then in the second situation is Giffen goods. So Robert Giffen has identified this. That is why it is known as Giffen goods. So during Irish famine has occurred due to the late blight of potato. So due to late blight of potato, potato crops around the Ireland has vanished. Only the stored potatoes were there. Then the people, out of scarcity, out of fear that the potatoes will not be available, and they purchased more and more quantity of potatoes. Out of fear of scarcity, they have purchased more number of potatoes even though it is priced high. So it is happening in now also in during the this COVID-19 outbreak. People tend to buy more and more vegetables like onion or ginger, garlic, etc. Due to the fear of scarcity. So and if the price, they think that the future price may go, they have created the demand. So during Irish famine, even though the potatoes price increases, the quantity of demanded of potato also increased. So it is known as Giffen effect, and these goods are known as Giffen goods. The third situation is when people think that price of the commodity might increase further. So it is, we have discussed like that, COVID-19 outbreak. In this time, the people purchased vegetables and other related goods out of a fear that price might increase further. So these three situations where even though the price increases, the quantity demanded also increases. Other than these exceptions, almost all the places law of demand applicables. So law of demand is very basic and important law in agricultural economics and in general economics too. So thanks for listening. Today we have seen that law of demand and its determinants, types of demand, and how the price and income affects the demand curve, and exception to law of demand. Thank you once again.